Historically, One Tree Hill in Auckland had a physical growing tree atop it, as well as the obelisk you can see there. So that tree got cut down by a Maori activist, leaving the obelisk remaining to this day. So it's One Tree Hill and it has an obelisk atop it. In a recent video I produced, I showed within the cemetery on the corner of Simon Street and Karangahape Road in Auckland, an obelisk within there, an eight-sided obelisk in this case, with the foliage sprouting out of it. And indeed I can show another one at St. Stephen's Church in Newtown, Sydney, a fine example of an obelisk with the foliage pouring out of the top of it. So with all this in mind, if we reflect back to the obelisk on One Tree Hill, what do we still have on One Tree Hill? Just a few weeks ago, I was talking over lunch with James Gilliland regarding, and I probably brought it up, Cirque du Soleil. And he mentioned that he had an ex-girlfriend. He wouldn't go on camera and sort of say this stuff because it's personal stuff and it's people he knows and stuff. But anyway, I'm going to give it a bit of a mention. So he had an ex, has an ex-girlfriend, and that girlfriend had connections with occultists within Cirque du Soleil. Now, I've featured Cirque du Soleil within my films time and time again. It was one of the things that really revealed things about the occult from my point of view. During the halftime performance at the Super Bowl of 2016, you have Coldplay's Chris Martin entering into the centre of the Magic Ritual edifice. First up, you would see the Flower of Life depicted on the floor there. That would refer to the lotus. It would also refer to the further geometries. Chris Martin would be part of the tree. He is the tree. His chakra system is part of the tree also, and those tubes, etc., these etheric tubes. Indeed, as part of the tree, as part of his illumination, and this is what illumination and Illuminati would essentially refer to, Illuminati essentially referring to bankers who want to take over the world, evil bankers, etc. That is pathetic. The word refers to light, further light, but don't tell researchers this. We don't want them to find out. So this stuff can be sort of depicted over and over again, and your general researcher out there is never going to have a clue. So we have the mage here, and he has entered into the center. He has entered through the fire and the water depicted here, and you can see it migrating around. That's part of the ritual scenario, and Peter Bajet spoke about this. But anyway, so he would be imbued with the elements of fire and water. He would be the balanced participant in the center. And we can see that on this modernized tracing board from Freemasonry. And indeed, if we go to the Sydney Masonic Center, we can see the water depicted in the center. We can see the fire depicted in the center. And we can see here what I would suggest is a depiction of the sun well. Now, many times over, now you could have pedestals on the outside of the ritual, or you could have participants with swords, or just participants on the outside of the magic circle. Each would be imbued with a various elemental energy, if you will. Each would be imbued with a various elemental energy, if you will. And they send these energies into the center. Now, in this shot, you can see Chris Martin, and you can see those entities around the outside there. And I would suggest that this is a depiction of them being imbued with a various element, if you will. And they can send that into the center, raising up the awareness and the energies of the mage in the center, in this case being Mage Chris Martin. Now, on his jacket, you can see the chakra, the heart chakra, depicted on the back, I would suggest. And indeed, you have the kind of reddish there and the bluish on his suit. And then if you look further at the detail, you can kind of see the rainbow color going up and other aspects that perhaps refer to the chakras. Now, in regards to the energies being sent into the center from the outside, you can see various depictions of this. For example, within the fifth element, within the movie there, and you can also see it within Ninjago, the Lego production there, where the energies are sent into the center from the imbued outer participants. And you can also see it within this depiction from World of Warcraft also, where you have the kind of sun world depiction there also. Now, Chris Martin the mage would be in the center, and you can see in this shot that you can kind of see below his feet, if you will. And this would be an indication, I would suggest, that his awareness has now gone beyond the physicality of the room, for example, that he is in. And of course, with all these edifices, they would be etherically magnetized. So in Tron here, you can see that depiction, I would suggest, of the etheric magnetism of the space. And you can see those chakras on the back of their uniforms also. In this case here, you can see the participants, both male and female, kind of depicted in the center, sort of signifying the energies of male and female, fire and water, if you will, the most predominant elements within the magic ritual scenario, or two of the main predominant elements, if you will, that are used and are part of the pentagram, etc. And by the way, with the pentagram, you will see depictions of it with the flower, the lotus also. So it kind of really ties in with this magic ritual space with the layout. So Chris Martin would be the tree in the center. He's part of the tree of life. Let's now skip to this image, and I believe this comes from Cambodia. It's a Buddhist image, and you can see the tree there and the emanations from the lotus, both atop the lotus and the emanation from the lotus. Now, this would be the tree of life, and I don't want to confuse things, but as Ledbetter sort of points out in his illustrations, you have that kind of lotus emanating from the amazing human body. Of course, this would be an aspect of the human body that the everyday person is not really aware of. And I keep drawing Freemasonry into it. And with that third degree tracing board, you can see what really is a depiction of the aura around the human body. Now, that Buddhist depiction would be replicated in Egypt, where again you see the lotus with the emanation, the etheric emanation from that interdimensional portal way. Now to the Olympics of 2012 that were held in London, and you had One Tree Hill right there. Indeed, you had the Maypole ceremonies around there also, which would relate to One Tree Hill with the ritual scenario. But just looking at that One Tree Hill for a moment, apparently the actors, the performers, came through that portal, and there is a stairway atop that hill, through that portal way, and into the what is an interdimensional space. You can also see the combination of the light and the tree. And indeed, if we go to Cirque du Soleil, you can see a combination of the light and the tree also, and that's coming out of the Julian footage. Goodbye for now.